big and lumbering. In Blood Bowl, there are as many ways to move as there are teams in the leagues.
If the other team can't catch you, you don't have to be tough.
But ain't it fun when they do, huh, Jim?
All the same, Bob, you're unlikely to win unless you can get the ball into the end zone a few times. Hey there, Alyssa, can you take a moment to walk us through the basics of moving?
Moving is simple. When you activate a player, you may move them any number of squares up to their MA characteristic in any direction. You may only move through unoccupied squares, which include squares with the ball. When a player has moved its full movement allowance, or as far as you want them to, it's time to move on to the next. Unless you fancy pushing it. A player may attempt to move an extra square by declaring that they'll rush. Roll a d6. On a roll of 2 or better, the rushing player moves without a mishap. If you roll a 1, they trip and fall over. More on that in a bit. If the player is still standing, they can choose to rush a second time. They just need to make that roll of 2 or more again. If your player began the turn prone and wishes to move, they must first spend 3 points of movement to stand up. Some models are so slow that even standing up is a feat. If a player has an MA of 1 or 2, roll a d6. On a 4 or more, they're able to use their entire MA to stand up. If they fail, they must remain prone. If your player is marked by one or more opposing players and wishes to move, they must attempt to dodge to vacate their square and move into another. To dodge, the player must pass an agility test. If they're moving into a square that's marked by one or more opposing players, apply a -1 modifier for each player marking them. If this agility test is failed, the dodging player will fall over. A player that falls over for any reason will become prone and cause a turnover. To add injury to insult, there's a chance your player will suffer, well, an injury. The opposing coach rolls an armor test against them as well. We'll talk more about those when we're covering blocking in a later video. Also, if the fallen player happened to be carrying the ball, it will also scatter when they fall over. And we'll cover that when we talk more about passing the ball. Speaking of balls on the pitch, a player must attempt to pick up the ball if they voluntarily move into a square in which it's placed. The player makes an agility test with a -1 penalty for each opposing player marking them. If they pass, the player is said to be carrying the ball, and they may continue to move if they're able. If they fail, the ball will bounce away. And with that, I'll pass the ball back to our announcers.
Well, we're just about to discuss the passing game, now you mention it.
Whether it's a ball or a teammate, an accurate pass is a game-winning move.